please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Let's talk about the big development in the corporate space. Tech major Infosys has filed a consent application with SEBI over former CFO's severance package. The application says the company wants to resolve all allegations of non-compliance with corporate governance standards and disclosure norms. Kritika Saxena joins us with the details. Kritika, take us through the content of this application and what does this mean for the company now?
Infosys has filed a consent application for SEBI. Let me answer some important questions. One, what is the settlement all about? The settlement is with respect to Rajiv Bansal's severance package that was given in October 2015, worth 17.3 crore rupees. Why exactly is the settlement being filed? What Infosys has outlined in its disclosure is that as per SEBI's required norms, two things were not done when the severance package had been or the settlement had been made with Rajiv Bansal, and that was making a disclosure to the Nomination and Remuneration Committee as well as seeking a prior permission from the Audit Committee. Now, these two points were important as per SEBI norms, and as a result of that, they are seeking a settlement with SEBI to ensure that they haven't violated any norms over here. Why now? What we understand is that there was no show cause notice as such that came in from SEBI, but with the new management coming in, they want to ensure that any areas, any loopholes, any points that were there which showed the ghosts of the past and had a possibility of being an issue in the future, they want to have all their bases cleared, and as a result of that, they have filed this application. Now, how long will the settlement process take? Typically, it takes between 4 weeks to 12 weeks. It could take longer as well if the process is intensive. What would the settlement really be? The settlement could be a monetary settlement. It could be perhaps going back to the drawing board and reworking the settlement and the agreement and the severance package with Rajiv Bansal. Or if SEBI does not find any major instance of wrongdoing or any violation of norms as such, depending on what SEBI really finds, there could be a possibility that there could just be a warning and just a notice given out to Infosys, and perhaps there may not be any monetary penalty at all.
Two major hospitals in the National Capital Region, NCR, Fortis as well as Gurugram, in Fortis Hospital in Gurugram and Max Hospital in Delhi. Both of them are in the dock, while Fortis Hospital is under scrutiny for reportedly charging 15 lakh rupees for the treatment of a 7-year-old dengue patient. Max Hospital is facing an inquiry for alleged negligence in dealing with newborn twins. CNN News 18 Sahil Mignani sent us this report earlier.
Important developments happening in two cases, both relating to medical apathy. In Fortis Gurugram case, very significant developments happening. State government's health minister going on record to say that there was negligence on part of the hospital. In fact, not just that, he has also recommended an FIR to that effect. And I just spoke to my sources in Gurugram police. They've already initiated proceedings in that direction. Since the minister mentioned the word negligence twice, what I've been told is section 304 of the IPC, which deals with negligence, is most likely to be invoked in this first information report, which will be filed in this case. Now, once again, just a quick recap for our viewers. The parents had alleged that on day three itself, they wanted the MRI scan to be done. That wasn't done. It was delayed till the 11th day. And when it was finally done, it revealed that 60 to 70% brain of the child was affected. The allegation coming in from the parents thereby is that this was intentionally done, that the doctors knew from day one that the child could not be treated upon, that there is no point carrying out the treatment, but they anyway went ahead with it just to inflate the bills. In the second case, which is of Max New Delhi, in which an alive infant was declared dead by Max Hospital, Delhi government has said that the preliminary report that they have got by a 3-member panel is that Max Hospital is guilty. That's a report coming in from the Delhi government saying that no ECG was done, which is important to ascertain whether the infant was alive or not. And thereby, Delhi government's preliminary the first report which has come in from the Delhi government saying that the Max Hospital is guilty. The Max Hospital is saying that this is not the final report. They will wait for the final report to come in to give their statement to it. The Delhi government saying that report will be out in 3 days.
Okay, so let's keep an eye out on those stocks and trade today. But on to our election coverage from Ground Zero in Gujarat. Rajkot is home to around 40,000 industrial units. As Gujarat gears up to vote, constituencies in this industrial belt will play a crucial role in the fortunes of the political parties. CNBC TV18's Archana Shukla visited Rajkot and the adjoining areas to find out how businesses have coped with the GST transition.
Rajkot's industrial belt is a major hub for small businesses. Ever since the launch of GST, many here complain that production and sales have been hit and managing compliances is becoming a tad difficult.
शुरू शुरू में क्या मैडम कि सबको ऐसा हुआ कि भी एक साथ में क्या आ गया तो उसके लिए तैयारी नहीं था उसमें भी खास छोटे आदमी छोटे इंडस्ट्रीज वाले के लिए जो बड़े इंडस्ट्री था उसको उतना कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं था साल भर में या छः महीने में लोग के पास दो तीन करोड़ रुपया तो ऐसे टैक्स में रुक जाता है तो क्या होता है वर्किंग कैपिटल के लिए प्रॉब्लम होता है तो इफेक्ट तो आया है जरूर इसीलिए एक्सपोर्ट भी कम हुआ है लोकल में भी प्रोडक्ट कम हुआ है तो वो इफेक्ट आया जरूर मगर हम लोग ऐसा मान रहे हैं कि ये आने के बाद अभी जो भी धीरे धीरे हो रहा है वो मतलब 1.5 मतलब डेढ़ गुना काम बढ़ जाएगा
इट्स नॉट जस्ट द हिट टू सेल्स Many businesses here are struggling to cope with the change in the way they transact after GST.
आप जिसको जॉब वर्क का काम देते हैं उन लोगों के पास क्या परेशानी हो रही है
उसके पास जीएसटी नंबर है नहीं वो लोग जीएसटी नंबर लेते नहीं है बराबर तो हमारा काम रुक जाता
अभी जब इलेक्शंस आएगा अभी जब वोटिंग करने आप लोग जाएंगे 9 तारीख को तो आप लोग को क्या चाहिए कि आगे आने वाली सरकार को क्या करना चाहिए आपके लिए
मैं तो चाहता हूँ कि भले फिर भी ऐसा हो लेकिन भाजपा भी आए भाजपा भी आए
आपके मन में क्या है आपको क्या लगता है जो भी सरकार आएगी
मेरे मन में
क्या
तो
चाहिए आपको
मेरे मन में ऐसा है कि सरकार को 5 साल को बदलना चाहिए कि एक 5 साल भाजपा आए 5 साल कांग्रेस आए किसी का काम अच्छा हो वो सरकार चुने मेरा वो है नियम
अभी आपको लगता है कि जो सरकार अभी है मौजूदा हाँ। सरकार वो कर रही है काम
वो अभी सरकार है उसने तो गरीब आदमी को बर्बाद कर दिया जीएसटी आया तो काम ठप हो गया
जीएसटी की जो वर्किंग है अभी उसमें किस तरह के इश्यूज आ रहे हैं आप लोगों को
जीएसटी में वैसे देखा जाए तो हमारे लिए जो जीएसटी इन लोगों ने इम्प्लीमेंट किया है हर एक प्रोडक्ट पे अलग अलग एचएसएन कोड के हिसाब से अलग अलग टैक्सेशन रेट्स हैं तो उसमें हमको काफ़ी दिक्कत आता है एक ही मटेरियल जो है उसको अगर प्रोसेस करने के बाद कोई एक टैक्स स्लिप में जाएगा कोई दूसरे टैक्स स्लिप में जा रहा है तो उसकी वजह से थोड़ा अभी परेशानी तो आ रही है जब तक हम उसको कोप अप कर पाए
कितना एचएसएन कोड है जो आप डील कर रहे हैं अभी
अभी हमारा 14 से 15 एचएसएन कोड है
आपको लगता है मोदी जी अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं
तो अभी तो नोटबंदी में परेशान हुआ तो कोई सोचता है मोदी जी को नहीं देना चाहिए
आपको लगता है यहाँ पे सरकार जो काम कर रही है वो आप लोगों के फायदे का काम कर रही है
हाँ मेरे हिसाब से तो लगता है
नोटबंदी जीएसटी आपको लग रहा है आपके फायदे के लिए
हाँ ना वो सही है आम मजदूर के लिए सही है अभी वो जो अच्छा काम करता है उसी को वोट देंगे अभी मोदी जी है तो उसको ही देंगे वोट
But taxation is not the only issue troubling Rajkot's industrial belt. Many here say the need for greater support from Gujarat Industrial Development Corporation is a consistent demand.
यहाँ का जो म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन है वही जीआईडीसी को संभालने के लिए तैयार नहीं है यहाँ के रोड रस्ते देखने वाला लाइट पानी सुविधा वगैरह कोई भी कॉरपोरेशन देखता नहीं वो हम सबको पर्सनल देखना पड़ता है
चाहे कांग्रेस आए भाजपा आए वी डोंट माइंड वी आर हियर टू पे द टैक्स बट हमको भी बेनिफिट मिलना चाहिए अगर आप बेनिफिट ही नहीं देंगे एग्जिस्टिंग को तो न्यू इंडस्ट्रीज कैसे आएंगे
विद अर्चना शुक्ला इन राजकोट इन मुंबई कृतिका सक्सेना
Let's shift focus to the world of commodities, wherein Manisha Gupta is standing by to get us a wrap of what's happening from the world of commodities. Manisha, crude is slipping in trade, overnight down about 3%.
Well, yes, and this is in the reaction to the U.S. weekly inventory data that came in last night, which shows that while there is a decline in the crude inventories by a big margin, but then you have seen a surge in the gasoline, natural gas, distillate fuel inventories. So that tells you that the demand really seems to be waning, and that's not a good sign, because if there are inventories of the products increasing, that means that crude demand going forward also would decline. And apart from that, you also have seen the U.S. production continue to gain up on a weekly basis. This is a record number that we have seen at 9.7 million barrels per day, and that's really pulled the prices down. So yes, 2.5 to 3% down for both the crude varieties. For the U.S. crude, we're trading at a two-week low, but for the Brent crude prices, we have now broken below $62 per barrel, and that's a one-month low coming in for that. So not so very good on charts, but this is expected because you have seen such a huge run-up in many of these commodities, and as mid-December approaches, you will see those speculative net longs going in for unwinding of their commodities. Not just crude, if you take a look at the metal space, today is the third straight day when you have seen a decline there. So you have a negative steel prices opening in Shanghai. Copper is the only one which is holding on the positive. Aluminum, nickel, zinc, all of that is trading on a weaker side. It is unwinding of positions, and also reports that China first half 2018 would be a weak demand scenario is also pulling money out of many of these metals.
All right, Manisha, thanks a lot for that. Indeed, metals are under some pressure. We're keeping an eye out on all those stocks as well. But talking about stocks, let's take stock of what's taking place in the futures and options space. The FIIs, they've been relentlessly selling in index futures. Over the last two trading sessions itself, nearly 2,500 crore rupees have been pulled out in the index futures space itself. Now, the short exposure has been increasing. At the series start, FIIs were short, 32%? And now that's gone higher to about 44%. So in absence of any further downside in our markets, we could perhaps see some short covering. There is a case for that. The index futures premium as well, they've been selling aggressively at the start of the series. Nifty futures premium was close to 52 points. That has halved in just about three trading sessions. As far as open interest in today's trading session is concerned, higher shorts seen in Nifty Bank. And remember, Nifty Bank weekly options expiry is there today. As far as the Nifty is concerned, a lot of aggression shown in writing at the 10,100 level, nearly 8.5 lakh shares added out there, and the 9,800 put has opened up. Yesterday we saw some action in the 9,900 put, so the sub 10,000 levels really opening up. As far as Nifty Bank options is concerned, 25,200, 25,100, 24,900, all these calls have come in for writing. Watch out for gen irrigation, that one enters the FNO ban.